Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Gaming on Caffeine. My name is Isaac, and we are back for some more Don't Starve Shipwreck. To last episode, we did, of course, die as Willow. So, today, we're going to start a brand new game. We're going to play some more Shipwreck. And I think this time around, we're going to start as Wilson, the gentleman scientist himself. He grows a magnificent beard. Did you know? So, we're going to start again. We're going to try and get further than day 21, which is, I think my high score forever. I don't think I've ever gotten past day 21 in Don't Starve at all. But this time around, I have installed a few new mods, including a hunger mod, which shows us how much each item is food is going to do, like, health-wise and hunger-wise, and I think even maybe sanity-wise, but don't quote me on that. I've also installed a few other mods as well that I'll kind of talk about as we come across them. One of them that we're going to come across right away is the fast collection mod. So now we pick up items like saplings and grass pretty much instantly, which is going to make it a lot easier to get further, I think, because it's going to mean that we can pick up stuff just that little bit faster. We can kind of harvest and do a lot more during the day, which is quite nice. It doesn't affect things like trees. Like, if I've got an axe or a tool that I'm going to use, we still have to use that to chop down the whole thing. It's not going to chop it down instantly or anything like that. So it's just a bit faster than it was before, and hopefully will make a little bit of difference. Things I want to do differently this time around that I didn't do last time. The first thing, most obvious thing, is not to build our base in between a battleground between bees and spiders. I think that's a bad idea. Don't build a base not too near bees. I don't think being, like, a safe distance away is too bad, but if you build right next to beehives, don't think that's a good idea. And I also don't think building so close to a spider spawner, even though it was only a small one, they do grow pretty quickly and kind of creep up on you like that. So scout out the area a bit. Don't build near a bee base. Don't build near some spiders. And I think we should be able to get a little bit further than day 21. Also, trees. We had a big problem with trees last time. We didn't have anywhere near enough wood, anywhere near really enough food, I don't think. So, like, if we could add this coconut tree, which I think I'm going to do right about now, because it's going to give us a nice early game source of food in the form of coconuts. But what we should probably do is actually replant those coconuts to get more coconut trees. Now, I'm not quite sure how beneficial that is, because we cut it down. Sometimes we get two coconuts, like right there. It would be beneficial because we doubled our amount of coconuts. But other times, you only get one coconut back. So I'm not actually too sure if it's worthwhile actually replanting coconut trees. Maybe we should just work on normal trees and not put our base in the middle of, like, the desert. But we'll see about that. I'm hoping I can get a few of these crabs before nightfall here. It shouldn't be too bad, because we do another trick now to where they stop on the second chase. So this guy shouldn't move, and we should be able to successfully attack him twice. Good stuff. Also, a bunch of people said that I didn't pick up anywhere near enough flint. And they also pointed out that we passed through, I think it's a magma biome, a lot in last episode. Actually, we were right next to one. And if you dig up the rocks in a magma biome with a shovel, I think you actually get some gold from that as well. And I was spending, like, the whole of last episode trying to get gold. So I've learned a lot since the last playthrough. And I think with games like this, it's going to take me, like, a few attempts to try and get used to stuff like that. Especially a game like this where you can die so early on. This island is real small. Not necessarily a bad thing, but I would have preferred it if it was a bit bigger. We're probably going to have to sail off. We'll probably do it tomorrow. I don't know if there's much point in doing it today. For now, we're just going to work on getting saplings, getting grass, getting flowers in case we need to make, like, a hat to reduce our sanity, all that kind of stuff. One cool thing about Wilson is he does have higher sanity than Willow had, so hopefully it won't be as big of a problem as it was before. There doesn't look to be a whole lot more, actually, on this island, apart from trees and coconuts, as well as a couple of these crabs. So what I think I'll do is I think I'll spend the last bit of today kind of gathering as much wood as I can, preferably come from these coconut trees, if possible, and at the same time try and grab as many of these crabs as I can to try and get a nice little food supply going before we build the raft and head on out into the distance and see if we can find another island. I did a little bit of testing on, I was testing to see if some mods worked on a single player world, like between this episode and last. And I got on a boat, and I must have sailed for about 5 minutes. So there were times when there can just be, like, a lot of ocean. Like, there was a huge stretch of ocean before I found any land, which was a little scary, because it means that there can be quite a long... I had to spend the night on a boat. I had to, like, build a torch and just stand there in the middle of the ocean on this raft, holding this torch, trying to stay alive. It was pretty weird. Hopefully that doesn't happen to us, because my sanity did go way down, and it also wasted a ton of time just kind of sitting there in the middle of the ocean with nothing to do. So hopefully that doesn't happen to us this time around. I don't think it will, but it is a possibility. It's almost dark time. Thankfully, it's kind of nice being at the start of the game again because daytime is so long. Whereas at the end of last episode, we had about like 4 or 5 daytime like slices on the clock over there. Speaking of which, you'll see it says mild 1 out of 20. I also installed a mod that tells me the current season and how long there is left of that season before the next season starts. So right now, we're in the mild season, I guess. And there are 20 days before the mild season. Ah, I forgot about snakes. I always forget about snakes. I guess snakes don't spawn in coconut trees. That could be something that we should bear in mind, because maybe that's going to help with like not dying to snakes. Also, I should probably just remember that snakes spawn in those trees, because they get me every single time. That is 10 health right down the drain, right at the start of the game. That is not good. That is not a good way to start. Our axe is broken. That is fine. What do we need for our first raft? We only need wood and grass, so that's actually pretty good. I will get more of these doubloons. I'm not quite sure what the point of these is. Like, we haven't found a use for them yet. If anyone does know the use of them, by the way, be sure to leave that in the comments. But for now, we kind of just have them. It probably is worth us making another hatchet here real quick, just to chop down some more of these trees. This time, being on the lookout for any snakes that might drop. One thing I am a bit concerned about so far is there's no gold on this island, so we kind of definitely are going to have to move out pretty quickly. Again, that snake kind of did us! Take me by surprise, it really shouldn't have. Also, probably shouldn't have taken damage there. We're at 130. I'm not too worried, because I think if we cook up all this crab meat, cook up the coconut, stuff like that, we should be fine to get ourselves up to almost full hunger again. I'm flickering around on the like viewpoint here, trying to see if any snakes spawned whenever that happened. Thankfully, they didn't that time. Bananas are good, actually. I was wondering what that was then for a second. We should probably pick those up and eat those as opposed to eating the coconuts tonight. Okay, we're safe. There are no bad guys. There's also an egg as well, which could be pretty good. Let's go ahead, and I think what we'll do is we'll set up a fire right about here. And for the rest of the night, we'll kind of work in this area. So let's pick up this banana. Let's get it cooked on the fire. We'll cook up these bananas. Did you get cooked bananas? I have no idea. But can we not eat it? I wish to eat this. There we go. Okay. So that did take us up a little bit on hunger as well. But for instance, now, if we... Oh, are the mods not installed, right? Oh, no, there it is. For example, fish morsel. If we eat it, we get 12.5 hunger as well as 1 health back. This egg, for instance. Let's go ahead and quickly drop these seeds, I guess. What does the egg do? Well, it only does 9.4. I think if we cook it, it's not going to do any more hunger, but it might do some health. Oh, no, it's gone up to 12.5. Nice. I think that's the case with seeds. Like, seeds right now do 4.7 hunger. If we cook them, it's still 4.7 hunger, but it also restores our health as well. So it is worth kind of cooking seeds, unlike last run, where we got a bunch of seeds, but then kind of just didn't cook them. We kind of ate them raw in an attempt to get our hunger up. It would have been much more beneficial if we'd have cooked them first, because then we'd have got the health benefits as well as the hunger benefits. And hunger benefits? I meant to say hunger benefits. I said hunger. But hey, that's fine. Let's have a look. We're on 115. Let's cook up a few. Actually, we might as well cook up all of these. I don't think there's any benefit to keeping them raw in our inventory, so we'll cook all those up whilst we're here. We might as well actually go ahead and cook up the berries, eat those. We need 12 in order to make the garland, so there's no point doing that yet. We'll cook up the limpets, and we'll eat those as well. That almost takes us back to full. I'm kind of dubious about eating any of our fish just yet. 12.5 actually does take us, I think, to 150, or just under 150 there, so that's fine. I'm not going to cook up the coconuts, because I would like to replant those, if possible, to get more coconut trees. That's the plan, at least. And everything looks good. Like, the sanity's not too bad. If needs be, we could always pick some more flowers and get some more stuff that way. What do we need for that? We should probably just make... I'm going to make a normal log raft for now. We probably should work on getting a better log raft. There's our start of the day lag. That is fine. But I'm hoping that we find another island somewhat nearby. So we're just going to kind of pick that and move along here. And hopefully... not have too many issues on our travels. The fast harvest mode does also make picking seaweed up just that little bit faster. And also, someone in the comment section pointed out that if we can ride the wave backwards, we do get a little bit of a speed boost. And actually, it looks like there might be another island fairly close to this one, which would be very nice indeed. So, Right now, we're kind of riding the wrong way to get a speed boost, but if you hit a wave going the other way, like if we were to hit one going this way, I think we would get a speed boost going the other way, which is pretty cool. Not quite sure why there's shallow water here. Usually, shallow water indicates nearby land. Apparently, in that scenario, it did not, but I do see some more, and I do see some land nearby as well. This is good. We're not going to spend half of our daytime hours just sailing the sea, which is very nice indeed. I'm not too bothered about grabbing a lot of seaweed just yet. One thing that we do need to work on that we didn't do last time is having an antidote ready, and also just in general not fighting anything that looks poisonous, because poison is pretty much a killer unless you have like the poison gland, which is a bit of a pain to get, because usually you've got to kill a monster that gives you poison in order to get that poison gland. So if we could not do that, that would be great. Our sanity is back up at full. This is not, oh, I don't know. I was going to say this is not the greatest island, but right now it doesn't look like it's too bad. There's a lot of flowers, which is nice. We can come back and get our sanity up if needs be. But I was kind of hoping for some gold. Doesn't look too likely so far, but the biome could go on quite far. There's some bees, so we're going to kind of not necessarily avoid them, but just not set up base right next to them. That's the plan, at least. I'm going to eat these seeds right now, even though I did say that we shouldn't eat them raw. I'm going to eat them right now because I don't want to set up a campfire. And also, I would like to grab as many of these sweet potatoes as is possible, because they make for quite a nice food source as well. Also, we need to keep like a mental note of where our raft is. It's there on the very left. That's fine. Let's grab you, and I'm also going to grab this sweet potato over here as well, as we did last time, kind of just making sure we have enough food to stay alive for the first, like, 10 days or so. That's kind of, like, our main priority. Also, sub-priority is getting a science machine so we can kind of start to advance and do stuff like that. This island looks absolutely awful. I'm going to grab the flint, because flint is always good. People had a right call me in the comment section of the last episode for leaving a bunch of flint behind. But this island looks kind of trash. It looks kind of terrible, to be fair. There's a lot of flowers, so if we need to come and get our sanity up, this looks like a great place. But other than that, grass, flowers are not what we're after right now. We are after gold, and we are after stone, I guess. Like a stone gold biome is what we need right now. Or maybe even the magma biome that we saw last episode. But that biome that we've got there, not what we're after. So we're back on the sea. I'm going to head north. I don't know if that's a good idea or not. It looks like we spawn kind of right in the middle of the map. So I think we can go in kind of all four directions here and still find stuff. Hopefully we'll find something further up here. This sounds like new music. I quite like it. I don't know if it is new music or if I was just talking over it before, but this music sounds kind of new. It's very peaceful. All right, here we go. This looks like a much nicer place to settle down. I see a lot more coconut trees. This is good. I see a lot more crabs. This is also good. I see some limpets. Limpets are also good. They do give us a nice source of food, which again, we should be cooking first. But right now, I don't have any inventory space. We don't yet have a place that we're kind of calling home base. Hopefully, it's not a really small island, although it looks like it's going to be. That's not particularly good. We do have some rocks, which I guess is nice. We're probably going to have to spend the night here no matter what, because right now we're on almost the end of day two, but it does look like this island, again, is going to be a pretty small one. Have we got anything that we can drop? I guess we could drop snake skin, but I don't really want to. And I don't think it's going to be too bad if we eat some raw berries and some raw seeds. But yeah, this island is tiny. We've got just like a ton of tiny islands. This is not good. I want one big island that I can traverse and find all kinds of stuff. Unfortunately, that does not seem to be the case. So I guess we're just going to keep on eating some limpets here, picking some more stuff. I'll cut down some more coconut trees. We'll try and get some more resources. And then again, when the day breaks, we're going to have to jump back onto the open waters and try and get ourselves to an island that has gold on, because right now, we don't have any. And without gold, we can't really progress in any shape or form. We're kind of stuck here. Until we can get some gold, which is not particularly great. I'm gonna drop the snake skin. I'm gonna drop the snake skin because I want to cook these limpets up, because I want to kind of try and get our health up a little bit. Does cooking limpets get our health up? I'm hoping it does, although I actually, if I'm honest, have no idea. I'm kind of still grabbing these saplings because I would like to be able to make tools whenever we like. We don't want the situation like last episode where we end up just not able to make the tools that we need in order to survive. And as always, we're going to grab as many of these coconut trees as possible whilst daylight is still upon us. Okay, so we're now on day 3, and I have found what looks like a somewhat promising island. I've continued my quest to head north. I kind of like this. Wow. This is a lot of berry bushes. Okay, what I'm going to do, I'm going to drop that. I'm fairly certain that we should be able to make a backpack. Here we go. The thatch pack is perfect, and we are going to pick as many of these as possible. Now, we can't make a shovel, unfortunately, until we get a, at least a science machine up and running, so until we get some gold. But as soon as we get a shovel, we are taking, like, every single one of these berry bushes over to our spawn, which, to be fair, we might actually set up over here. We might just set up base down at the bottom here next to all of these berry bushes, which hopefully will like, regrow on their own. I don't think they need... I think you have to put manure on them only if you, like, pick them up with a shovel and put them down somewhere else. So I think for now, we should be fine. This looks really nice indeed, and I kind of like the little green thatch pack that we got on our back there. That is kind of cool. All we need now... is some gold. If we can't get any gold, then even if, no matter how big this island is and how big or how many berry bushes it has, it's still not going to be particularly great. We might, even if it doesn't have gold, we can probably still come back and call this like a home base, but it does mean we're going to have to do a little bit more exploring if it doesn't. This looks like the end of the island, and it is. I was just checking. Maybe it went on and it was like a really small path that went over. This looks like it could be promising. So there's a pond there. This is good. A pond means that we can do some fishing. That I'm not too big of a fan of because a little eye popped out and looked at me when I looked at the pond. Wow, really? We've like hit the end of the island already and there's nothing here? Oh no, gold! Gold! Oh my goodness, look, we have been saved. Okay, here we go. Pickaxe. I see two here. That means that we should, at the very least, get two pieces of gold, which I believe is exactly what we need to make ourselves a science machine. So I will take all of that for now. I'm going to eat these seeds. So I want to pick all of this stuff up. The flint is good, the stones are useful, and the gold is exactly what we are looking for. So, there we go. 3 gold is perfect. I think 4 gold would have been nicer. On a 3 gold is actually fantastic because 3 gold means... Oh, no, it's not because a doodad needs 2. Ah, it's almost perfect. We need one more gold in order to make a doodad, I think, there. Because the doodads, we need 2 doodads. Each one needs 2 gold. So we need 4 gold to make an alchemy engine, as well as 1 to make the science machine. So we didn't... We were quite a way off, actually, in all fairness. But there is a ton of berries here. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to set my science machine down for now right here. We've got a lot of trees. We've got a lot of food. There's some thatch. There's some vines. There's some rocks. This looks like a nice, even place. We can't plant our coconut trees, which is a bit of a shame. There's no lobsters, which is also a bit of a shame. But I like this. I kind of like this a lot. We might also be able to go to the left as well. Let's do a little bit more. I'm going to do a little bit more exploring. I'm going to kind of hold off on... Oh my god, there's more gold as well. Here we go. I'm going to kind of hold off on doing a ton of stuff at the science machine just yet. That takes us to 3. We need one more for an alchemy engine. Because we can do all that stuff at night. We can like kind of sit around our campfire and do all that stuff then. And I think we should have enough stone as well now. Or almost enough stone to make... Well, we're not quite there, actually, to be fair. But we have a lot of stone. And hopefully, that is going to allow us to make a permanent campfire that we can leave by our base as well, which is quite nice. We did kind of make the mistake again of building very close to the shore. So we might have to invest in sandbags again at some point. But I don't think that's going to be too big of a deal. I think it should be fine. One thing I will do real quick before day dawns is I'm going to make myself a machete. No space. I'm going to eat these limpets here. But I'm going to equip this machete and we're going to do a quick like harvest of this stuff here. Actually, we don't have enough inventory space, do we? Okay. What we're going to do, we're going to head back. We're going to set up a chest. We're going to put away some of this stuff we don't need, like the doubloons, like the seashells, like probably... I don't know, my pickaxe? I want to keep that with me, I think. But we're going to put away some of that stuff for now. And when we come back later... Oh god, there's a snake. Hopefully I'll get bored as I walk back. So I don't want to put down this bamboo that we've got. Although, to be fair, this bamboo is not all that valuable. Ooh, there was somebody here as well. They dropped a pickaxe. Where did I set up base? I set it up further to the left here? Yeah, further to the left and up. Actually, we're not that close to the shore. We're a little bit close... But I don't think we're so close as to that we have to worry about any kind of water kind of coming in. So for now, gonna drop that there. Not a fan of the fact that we have snakes nearby. Multiple snakes at that. Okay, let's just kill this guy. Okay, he's dead. What? Is this something I've got to worry about with every single one of these little nests? I'm hacking at this thing. Wow. That... Oh, that could be pretty bad. Let's quickly get a fire going. I think fire is priority number one. Let's put that down, like, I guess here for now. so we can continue on through the night. Then let's go near our science machine and let's see what we can get going. So we can make a proper backpack. I think that's probably going to be a good idea. We'll do that. We'll drop the thatch pack in a second. For now, let's take that. Let's move some stuff over that we don't necessarily need. Let's pick up the thatch pack real quick and take the stuff out of there. Then let's pick up our normal backpack, and the thatch pack can forever just stay on the floor there. Cool. All right, let's pick up all this stuff. Don't really need, you know what? I can't do it with that, I don't think. You know what? We're going to leave that thatch pack there and try not to pick it up. We don't need the monster meat either, but for now, we can keep all of it just for, because why not, I guess. We'll eat a few of these cooked fish and try and get us up to almost 150. 148 is fine. We can now make a shovel, which might be a good idea. We can bring as many of those berry bushes kind of as close as possible, if needs be. I would like to get towards the alchemy engine at some point. That would be nice, but also I think that priority number one is going to be the crock pot, because if we can get the crock pot going, we can actually start to make ourselves, we can put the berries into the crock pot and start to make fistfuls of jam. And fistfuls of jam should give us a lot more health and hunger than the actual berries that we've got right now. So we need charcoal, we need stone. We do not need snakes attacking us in the middle of the night. That is one thing that we don't need. Oh my goodness. I'm going to have to go around and hack all of these things. I don't want that backpack. Can I not hack this with my machete? Oh my gosh, what is... Oh gosh, I'm on fire. I saw something in the distance there. What? What is this? It's fireflies. I can't do anything with the fireflies. Can I not just break this? Do I have to like dig this up with a shovel or something? I'm not too sure. We've burned some stuff, but that's fine. That's fine. So we need a crock pot. For that, we're going to get some more stone so we can make ourselves some of the refined stone. Let's have a look here. What do we need? We need cut stone. 3 normal stone makes 1 cut stone. And we need how much cut stone in order to make a crock pot? We need 3. So we need 9 cut stone. We need 9 normal stone. We need 6 charcoal, as well as... Oh, it keeps moving when I walk away. As well as some saplings. So one more sapling is fine. Charcoal we can get by burning trees. So I guess we're going to have to make some kind of torch. I don't want to do it too close to my berry bushes, just on the off chance that it like completely destroys them and I lose my like main source of food right now. Also, something to bear in mind, we're not completely tied down to this area here. We can always move in the future if needs be. If we want to, we can hammer up our science machine and we can move elsewhere. That's something that we can do. So we're not necessarily tied down to this snake-ridden jungle that we have found ourselves in. I think what I'll do here is I'll make a torch real quick and try and get as much charcoal as I can from these trees. I did use some of our saplings. I'm not seeing many saplings around right now. I want to make sure not to light myself on fire here. So I'm going to move out of the way. Let's go start lighting things on fire. I don't see any saplings, which is a little unnerving. I would like to try and find some more and get some of those if possible. But let's equip our hatchet real quick. And then once these trees have burned down, we'll harvest all the charcoal. Whilst we're waiting for that, let's get some stuff done. Let's go ahead and mine these rocks so we can get some of all that cut stone going. Good stuff. Still not sure what we're going to do with this niter here. So again, I'm just going to kind of drop it for now. I know some people are probably going to be shaking their heads at that for flipping whatever reason, because it's probably really useful. But I kind of don't want to. I'm also going to eat these seeds again against my better judgment, because I want to clear up some inventory space. We do need to make a chest as soon as we get back, because the chest is going to help massively in clearing our inventory. But here we go. We'll take this. That's going to get us 4. I think this one's only going to give us 1, so it's only going to take us to 5, which is a bit annoying because we need 6 in total, but we can light this tree on fire. There we go. And while we're waiting for that, I did get burned, but that's fine. Let's go back over here. Let's equip our axe and let's grab a little bit more stone. This is good. This is going to take us up to the 9 stone that we need, which is nice. I'm going to leave this on the floor again because I don't want it. And I'm also going to go ahead and cut this down here. There we go. We'll grab you. And now all that we need are the saplings. We just need a few more saplings. We are currently on 3. We need 6. So it is a pretty big ask. We need 3 more saplings to make this work. I kind of want to get these butterfly wings. Oh, the frogs, but not frogs. Oh, I see how it is. I see how it is. Let's plant these trees down. We could plant them closer to us, but I think this is fine for now. That was not too bad. That was not too bad. It was a bit unnerving, a little scary. We do have to watch out for snakes. I might move from here. This place is a little hostile, especially compared to kind of the beaches that we've been used to, where the only real threat is if you happen to be near snakes or spiders. Also, flipping, there are no saplings. There are no saplings on this island. What? Oh, there was, did we not examine down here? I guess we didn't. Okay, first things first. This gold is mine. Ah, the pickaxe book. Also, we don't need to get that because there's a pickaxe like right here, right? Yes, there is. I'm going to take that. Thank you very much. It's about halfway broken, but that's fine. It was free, so I'm not going to complain. This should give us enough gold to make ourselves an alchemy engine. I feel like this... Oh, gosh, dang it. Mother trucking, son of a gun, it's a snake. Okay, I was about to say, literally about to, like, jinx myself. I was about to say, I think this is a better start than the one we had before. He says as he gets attacked by snakes from the middle of nowhere. But I think it is legitimately better than what we had before. Let me look here real quick at what we need to move our science machine, because I think we might pack up and actually leave this island. We'll probably dig up all these berry bushes and move them at some point. But for now, we got a shovel, hammer. We can make a hammer. We can make a hammer. So what I think I might do here is, yeah, I think we have to hammer this up because we don't have enough twigs to make a a crock pot, and we have to go to another island to get it anyway. So what I think I'm gonna do, gonna get this, gonna hammer this guy, which turns it back into its base elements, which is fine, because we do now have enough gold and enough enough gold to make an alchemy engine and a science machine come next episode. Also, is that true? Yeah, I don't think we quite got our value's worth out of the like the stone and the logs, but that's fine, that's fine. We didn't not get our value's worth, we did get some back, which is nice. And to be fair, stone and logs are not all that big of a deal. We can get more of those any time that we need. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna quickly grab as many of these berries as we can get our hands on before we leave the island here. I should probably also pick up that stone. I might end up spending the night here because it is almost the end of the day and I'm not quite sure how long it's going to take us to find a new island. So far, it has taken a fair bit of time to get from one island to the next. So what I think I might do is I think I'm going to spend the rest of this day kind of going around, picking up some berries, getting as many of these as we can before we have to like kind of sail out. Do we have what it takes to make a better boat yet? We don't, although we could get the stuff. Because I think also a better boat would be kind of worthwhile at this point, because our current boat is not the best. It's probably going to wear out pretty soon. And so what I'm thinking is we grab as much of this stuff as we possibly can. We need four of those. We've got the three of these that we need. So we just need four of the bamboo, is it? Yeah, we need four bamboo. We've got two. Let's grab you. And then let's grab one more. And I think we should be pretty much good to go. So let's have a look. Which boat can we put? That's still just a raft, which is a bit of a pain. We need a logs for a rowboat. Okay, so we're not going to do any of that stuff yet. Instead, what we're going to do, we're going to do a little bit more scouting. I know it's getting dark and there are snakes everywhere. Jeez, snakes everywhere. You know what? Actually, you know what we're going to do? We have a torch, right? I'm pretty sure I made a torch. Yeah, it's in my backpack over here. I'm going to go. I'm going to get on my raft. I'm going to stand in the ocean with my torch because these snakes, it's not worth staying on this island. There are so many snakes. Like, so many snakes. It's crazy. So we're going to make our way back. It's almost the dead of night, but that is fine. We're going to head back. We're going to not spend the night on the island infested with snakes. Instead, we're going to get on here. It might affect our sanity a little bit. We're going to head out just a smidge. And then as soon as it gets to the darkest time, this blue section here, we're going to go ahead and switch over to our torch. I think 66% should be enough to keep us going throughout the night. If it's not, we can always go ahead and equip this other torch, which we cannot do because we don't have enough stuff. If it's not, then we're screwed. I'm really hoping that it's going to be. And I guess we're about to find out. If it's not, I'm going to stand somewhat close to the island here. So if it's not, we can quickly try and whip out a normal fire on the island. But I'm really hoping that we just don't have to deal with the snakes. And instead, we can just use our torch. So here goes nothing. I don't think this has been a bad four days start. I think it's been better than we did last time. You know, we've got stuff to make a science machine and an alchemy engine by day five, which is pretty nice. It's not the best in the world. I think we could have done better if we found gold faster, like spawn right near, so we could have probably got pretty far pretty quick. But overall, I think it's been pretty good. Let's eat, I guess, some of these, like, sweet potatoes. Again, we shouldn't be eating them raw. We definitely shouldn't be eating them raw. We should be eating them when they're at their maximum potential. But with that, guys, I think I'm going to end this episode of Don't Starve Shipwreck there. Thank you for watching. If you did enjoy the video, as always, be sure to hit that like button. I think this torch is going to last us throughout the night here. Daytime is almost approaching. It's going to be close. Oh, no. Oh my god, we did it. Okay, All right. Oh, my goodness. Oh, I heard the noises. I thought we were going to die. With that, guys, thanks for watching. I will see you next time.